Good morning, this is Jonathan for Drain Doctor. We are at 443 Timawana Road in Waikanae. Job number is J16271A. At the moment I'm CCTVing a stormwater line. As you can see, we've got some dirt and debris down at the end of the lens there. But more importantly, we have a pretty bad dislodgement. Right, so we're about 5 metres down. I think it's heading toward a soak pit because the other down pop-up camera is heading towards this point as well, not out to the road. But we have this major displacement right here, as you can see, that I cannot get past. So I'll pull back from here, get a shot of this one. See, there's the top end of the displacement there, which I've marked on the ground. Another displacement, actually, that one there is open to the outside of the pipe. You can see that clearly, tree roots and stuff on the outside of that joint there. Minor tree roots coming through there. Again, I think this is just, they're just field drains, to be honest. They'll just be butt jointed together. Again, which leads me to believe that this is a soak pit line as opposed to a drain out to a main. A little bit of silt in the bottom here, there's a big rock right there, you can see that. It's about 30-40% of the circumference of the pipe there. Just coming up around the bends, and we're out. We'll give you a shot of where we come from. So that downpipe on the corner, we've got another downpipe around there by the deck, and we've got another one there, you can maybe see it. We're going to jump back over to that one there, and I'll push the camera down there now, and you'll see that we reach the edge of the soak pit there, what I think is the soak pit. Make sure the lens is clean. Alright, we'll jump back into the first one that I've already cameraed, and we'll go down there. Alright, let's give you a shot of where we are. So it's this downpipe here, water tank's there, front door's in there, there's the road. Changes to earthenware, open joint there. And we come to the sandy soak pit right there, which I've marked on the ground. I'll give you a shot of where I've marked that. From where I believe the soak pit is. So there's one there, 1.3 metres, 0.8 metres, and that's where they're converging, right there. I'll stop recording here. One moment, let me just get this back. Oh, come on now. Yeah, I'll stop recording here. The next set we see will either be, actually I can just go jump straight down the sewer, to be honest. I'll go jump down the sewer, and then we'll do the next stormwater after that. Right, we're about to go down the sewer. This is the kitchen galley trip. I'm hoping that this is the top of the sewer line. So kitchen galley, there's the path out behind the trees there. It's going to go down here. It's going to pull that stuff out, which I'm not too keen on doing, because it's gross. Yuck. Alright, we'll go through here and have a look at what we can see. So like the other drain, the stormwater, it's 100mm earthenware. You get a major dislodgement 2 meters down, drop into water, zero visibility. Zero visibility. Hopefully that's just something on the lens there. I'm going to pull out from there and we'll see if I can picture back. Yeah, I should have pictured here. Alright, try that again. So displacement, dropping into liquids, try not to get the muck on the screen, so we'll just push down as far as we can, hopefully we're going to get some picture, there we go. We have a hard time with this one, I think. So I'm going to get some water running down, bear with me a moment. Just running some water through the kitchen tap now. And hope's there. There we go, we've got a better image. Give me a moment. We'll just flush the strain. That's a decent picture. Another change of direction there. Yeah. Underwater, this is never great. So we've got a loss of gradient on the bend there. Change to PVC. Come on, let me show that PVC. You see it changes there? Fat on the screen. We're in PVC pipe. PVC pipe down 15 meters. Can't see a blooming thing. I'm going to redo this, to be honest. I'm going to stop recording here and I'm going to push down a marker, then I'll come back out and redo this.